The show's continuing coverage of AA Northeast League Baseball is on the air. Tonight, game two of this three-game weekend series between the New Hampshire Fisher Cats and the Portland Sea Dogs. It's Baseball on the Show, and it's coming up next. Chris Murphy is on the mound.
Three.
Stepping in next, Lorenzo Hierholz. First cuts for him here with the bases open and two away. Into center field, line drive base hit. So he picks on the first pitch here and is able to extend the inning.
No mistake what he was sitting on, looking for a dead red piece of cheese middle of the plate, and he didn't miss it.
Batting four.
Runners off for second. Pitch outside. The throw is going to be far too late. That's a stolen base.
It was pretty obvious he would likely be on the move with two outs, and I'm sure the defense knew it too. But he has lightning speed and was able to take the bag anyways.
Runner breaks for third. Pitch taken for ball four. The throw not nearly in time as he takes third easily. So stepping in is Nick Decker. Potential tying run for him at third base. Oh, he pulls the string on the circle change. One and two.
Hey, great job by the offense right here to put a number up on the board and allow this young gun to go out on the mound. Relax.
We'll have to press pause as that strike three to retire the side. At the plate now is Lorenzo Hierholz. He collected a base hit his first time up. And a foul tip held onto here at strike one.
The offense better get it going right here because they certainly can tell from their dugout this guy is carrying himself with a presence out on the mound. He's got.
And we'll just leave it there as they make the play to end the inning. Pretty painless half of the inning. Ready to go for the last half of the inning. And standing in is the DH, Lorenzo Hierholz. First pitch here misses wide, 1-0. And a fastball in there for a strike, 1-1.
What a well-executed fastball right there, down and away. If you're going to do any damage with that pitch, you have to think up the middle the other way, and you have to be diving and leaning out over that thing.
To two balls and two strikes now.
I know he missed with a fastball right there, but this guy's arsenal, you can't figure out what he's trying to do. He's got a lot of different directions he can go in right here.
Make the turn, find the ball.
Throw on to first in time, one away. Next to dig in, Lorenzo Hierholz. He bounced out last time up.
Yeah, I understand that, Matty, but this guy's got burner wheels down the first baseline. I don't think he even concerns himself with that. He has to put it on the ground. That's part of what makes him successful.
There's a hard hit ground ball. Pitcher not able to get a glove on it. Hard single up the middle.
Yeah, watch your lips right there, Dad. Sent it back right where it came from.
Joey Murray is called upon with two out in the eighth as he's asked to complete a four-out save. And they still don't get him as he's in safely at second with a stolen base. Now the 2-1. Runner goes for third. In there. Now the throw. In there easily as the throw bounces on the way down.
You know, I was pretty surprised to see him on the move to third because it didn't seem like he had that much of a lead, but he made it work out. That was really impressive.
Hoping to send him packing, pitch on its way. And a half-hearted swing there as they tie him up in. This evening's game finishes 2-0 the final score. New Hampshire jumped out to an early lead in the first and never looked back.
Two runs, six hits. No error. They left 22 runners on base.
Time for minor league baseball here on the Dylan Covey starts the game on the mound for the third and final game of the series. Dan Plesac, what's the word on him?
Wow, talk about a number that jumps out at you. This guy's whip, which is walks to hits to innings pitch, is less than one coming into this start. That's not an easy thing to do. That tells me one thing. Not only is his stuff good, but he wipes people out quick. This is a real good pitcher.
Next up, Jordan Groshans. And in case you haven't been keeping up the tabs on him, arguably he's been one of the hottest hitters in the league over the last seven or so games.
Boy, you know, D-Row, every pitcher loves that. Shortstop does it.
Now at the plate, here is Lorenzo Hierholz. Two's all over the place. Two on, two out, and of course, here in inning number two. Pareda on second. Tobias on at first with two down. Well hit the other way, and it's into the gap. Pareda rounds third and is digging for the plate. He comes across to score as they move on top 4-0. Into the box, Jordan Groshans.
Now batting, shortstop, Jordan Groshans.
Now this is slowly hit to short, probably too slowly to get two. There's one, return throw not in time, and that turned into a closer play than I thought it would at first sight. Ready to go in the bottom of the fourth. And standing in as the switch hitting second baseman, Lorenzo Hierholz. Liner in there for a base hit.
There's another line drive leadoff single right now. I mean, they have an unbelievable scouting report on these pitchers today. They are finding barrels. They are not trying to do too much. Guys are
Meanwhile, here the throw down to second is not in time, and it's a stolen base. Well, when a stolen base is that close, it's interesting to check it out on ShowTrack. And as the numbers come in, you'll want to focus on the top speed. Really good, and it paid off there. But he gets back in time, safe at second base. Hierholz leads off second with one gun in the inning. And now the runner's trying for third. Strike called. Now the throw down is well behind the play. That's an easy stolen base.
You know, I was pretty surprised to see him on the move to third because it didn't seem like he had that much of a lead. But he made it work out. That was really impressive.
Swing and a miss on the changeup, and there are two gone. Next, it'll be Nick Decker.
Now batting, right fielder, Nick Decker.
Outside, 2-1. Well, you don't need us to tell you it's really starting to come down out there. I can't imagine the umpires will let this go too much longer if it doesn't ease up.
Well, you could say that again, Matt. It's raining cats and dogs out there. Make sure you don't step in a poodle. I think it's time to get the grounds crew out.
A swing and a drive sent out toward the gap. Racing back to center fielder. And this will hop over the wall, but the run will score. And now in the box, Chris Aguila. He went down looking in his last trip to the plate.
Yeah, always frustrating to go down looking. Everybody does it, though. You'll have a few ABs where you get completely fooled. Look for him to be on the attack early in the setback.
And the fifth inning will start with a ground out, one away. Now to the plate, here is Lorenzo Hierholz. And he's got runners at the corners here with only one gun. Pulled toward right center field. Long run for the center fielder, lays out, and he's got it. A great play for out number two. In to score is the runner from third. Now a 9-2 ball game. Ready now is Desan Brown. He's got a hit in three at bats to this point. Looking to wiggle out of this, here it is. Slider swung on and grounded towards short. And the two out threat won't pay off. The inning is over. So it's no runs on two hits. Next to hit is Lorenzo Hierholz as he'll dig into the left-handed batter's box.
I'm so impressed with him and his ability to hit from both sides of the dish. I mean, we've all seen guys that do it, but really, they usually struggle from one side of the plate or the other. Not him, though. He's a true switch hitter who has a lot of success from either side of the box.
A ball and a strike now. Bouncer up the middle, fielded cleanly, and that will conclude matters here in the seventh. And this ball game ends at a 9-4. The first.
One of the most underappreciated.
A player is called to question by his manager on his base running of late. Haven't had a little perverse fun with the. He checks that the player understands what. Even the best bag snatchers need to know when to exercise restraint. minor league manager checks in to see if this young man is inclined to make any adjustments to the club's current plan for his development. The player affirms that he's still on board with the original plan. A player receives a check-in from one of his coaches.
The game's future stars.
You're out.
Set to get his evening at the plate started, Salvador Avila trying to get it going at the plate. It's been tough sledding for him so far this year. Throw cleanly into first, and that ends the inning. Nothing doing here in the opening half inning. So it's on to the bottom of inning. Digging in, switch hitter Lorenzo Schierholz, as the switch hitter will bat right-handed here. This is hit pretty well out to left field. Avila has to retreat to the track, but he has it to retire the side. Second inning set to go, and next it'll be the switch hitting first baseman, Michael Tolia. Sent on the ground out to second. He's right there on the first, and there's one gone here to start the second. Bottom of the inning now, and that'll bring in the second baseman, Lorenzo Schierholz.
The old adage, pitching and defense have been stellar so far. They've served
in the dirt, and oh, he can't quite dig it out.
And that play is indicative of how their entire season has gone so far. They make the routine plays difficult, and if there's a tough play, they really struggle with it. They need to tighten up their fundamentals so they can get back on track.
Hoping to send him packing, pitch on its way. Lifted the other way to left center. Center fielder giving chase, and he tracks it down. Nice play for the first down. So one gone in the inning here with a runner at first. And digging in next is Jeter Downs. And he gets him to pop it up on the right side of the infield. And he'll reach first safely. He lays out for it, but he can't pull it in. And he's safe.
Boy, D-Roll, that ball wasn't hit very hard, but when you're struggling like this guy is, any knock is a good knock. Right.
Yeah, 100%. He doesn't usually get those. He has to square it up mid-barrel to find a way to get it.
And both runners are safe. The double steal executed perfectly.
You know, I was pretty surprised to see him on the move to third because it didn't seem like he had that much of a lead, but he made it work out. That was really impressive.
The 2-2. Well, if you love pitching and defense, this has been a game for you. Are you happy with that, Dan?
Oh, you have to love it. You know, Matt, we have so many of these games that are 12 to 10 and 9 to 8. It's nice to see a low-scoring pitcher's duel for once.
I love the fact there was no panic at second base right there.
Now to the plate, Lorenzo Schierholz. He's 0-2 thus far in this one. Swinging a little blooper to center. Gomez is there to make the catch, and the side is retired. So no runs here, no hit. So now it'll be the four-hole hitter, Michael Tolia. He was retired after popping out in his last at-bat. To second for one, on to first to complete the double play. Next up is Michael Tolia. He's hitless in three at-bats to this point. Tolia. Oh, it's on the ground to second. Did he get his double play? To second for one. On to first, and they turn the double play. And now, Lorenzo Schierholz. Base knock to the outfield could score the tying run from second. And the indication from the dugout comes, it looks like they're going to put him on intentionally. New inning set to get underway. And next to bat will be the outfielder, Jameson Hanna. Looking for the strikeout. Here's the 1-2. Hard hit ball to second. He's got it. Throw on to first for the out. And that is how the ninth inning gets underway.
the victorious Seahawks. 4 runs on 9 hits. No errors. They left 9 runners.
Minor League Baseball is live and on the air on the show. Tonight, the second of three to start. So now, here is Lorenzo Schierholz looking to put them ahead early with this at-bat. Ready to deal. Here comes the first pitch. Now a good pitch around the knees, but it doesn't quite catch the bottom of the zone. Well, you take a look at our visiting club as they take the field tonight. They come in the midst of a stretch where they've dropped 6 of their last 9.
Yeah, Matty, this road trip's been a little bit of a struggle for this team. First 4 games, they find themselves 1-3, haven't played particularly well. They'll find a way to regroup. They have to find a way to play a little bit more fundamentally sound. Start there first.
Catch is made. Runner tagging from third. The run comes across to score, and they jump ahead 1-0.
Great job there.
Stratting forward now is the DH. Lorenzo Schierholz notched an RBI on the sack fly in his previous turn at the plate. And that misses inside 1-0.
Hey, this is a left-handed hitter that can fly down the line. If they want to turn two, they're going to have to be almost perfect.
Count even now at 1-1.
Hey, usually the second time through the order, you start seeing an incorporation of some more off-speed stuff. But this guy's locating and feeling really good about his fastball. Two back-to-back.
2-1. Hits it high and deep out to center field. Center fielder going back. A leaping effort, and he brings it in. Two away now after a great effort. And he'll take those extra 90 feet, so put runners at the corners now with two gone in the inning. Stepping in once again is Lorenzo Schierholz. He hit a sack fly earlier.
Lorenzo.
Shin high. That's Schierholz. Taken for a ball. One out, nobody on. Lofted in the air out toward right center. Right fielder is on the run. He makes the play. Really had to hustle to get to that one. Two gone now. Bottom of the sixth inning now. And digging in is the DH, the switch hitter, Lorenzo Schierholz.
Lorenzo
pulled toward right center field. Jones has it, and it's a quick out number one. So now into the box is Lorenzo Schierholz. He flew out in his last AB. And a fastball misses here to start the at-bat. It's 1-0.
You know, because this is just a one-run game, this doesn't strike me as a situation where he's going to be working around a guy. I think he's going to challenge him right here.
Gomez retreats to... Now at the plate is Lorenzo Schierholz. A two-out hit and win it. Pass ball or wild pitch would do the trick just as well. Ball one to start the at-bat. Hit hard toward second. That ball's down, and in comes the winning run. And they're going to walk off here with a 5-4 win.
Always great when a game really comes down to the ninth inning like it did here. They had a chance to walk it off and send their fans home happy, and that's exactly what they did. Lots of smiles around here right now.